So I've just finished filming my new classic albums course, looking at Rush's 1981 album, Moving Pictures. It's been absolutely amazing having the chance to break down all seven tracks from the album, including the solos and the arrangements. And I've learned so much about Alex Lifeson's awesome and unique approach to playing guitar in a three-piece. I think anybody that picks up this course is not only going to learn these classic songs from this classic album, they're also going to learn a really unique way of approaching rock and progressive guitar with riffs, solos, phrasing on one string, the use of slides and exotic scales, and also unique chord voicings as well, using chord voicings in order to get unique arpeggiations, to get those really cool riffs, odd time signatures, the lot. So there's a lot to pick up here. So this course is really aimed at the intermediate to advanced player. However, what's great about Rush's music is there are lots of elements within it which are simple enough for beginners to pick up, and also challenging enough for beginners to expand their technique and musical awareness with some of the riffs presented here. So there's a lot to get at for all levels. If you're a fan of Rush, you should definitely check out this classic albums course, and if you're not a fan of Rush, you need to check it out anyway, because there's so many things you can learn from this, and Rush are just a fantastic band to get into as a guitar player. So hope you'll join me on this journey. I'll see you soon at LickLibrary. Okay, so this next riff is quite challenging timing-wise to know when it comes in exactly, because it's all live recorded in the studio, which is part of Rush's brilliance and how they gel as a band. Here's this riff. Okay, so I sort of see this in three mini sections. We've got this first run, which is on the A string. We're going to use our index finger on the third fret, then shift with our index finger to the fourth fret on the A string. We're going to climb up a three-note string scale from that fourth fret on the A. So three slide up to four, then six, seven on the A. And then on the D string, we're playing the exact same frets. So far you should have. And then we're going to go to the G string, four, six. And then on the B string, 4-5-4. So let's put that in with the first bit. Then finishing off this first section with, which is 6-5 on the G. Okay.